The South African mainstream media, it's not even hiding its intentions anymore. They are showing us their cards that, yeah, we don't like EFF, we don't like MK Party. And okay, we know the playbook when it comes to them reporting news about the EFF. They're always trying to make the EFF come across as if it's a negative thing. It's fine. But the MK Party is a new party. Ever since the MK Party was started, the news, how they report about the MK Party, it's always to discredit President Jacob Zuma, discredit the MK Party, make it seem like it's something it's not, but in a negative light. And I know I'm not an MK Party member, I'm an EFF member, I'm EFF, but I can't sit back and allow the same playbook that is used to discredit the EFF, to tarnish the brand of the EFF through media, through mainstream media, through journalists, to be applied to the MK Party. I won't allow it. And I see it. And I was still observing, trying to see. But now I see it. And it makes me wonder, why is even MK Party also hated like this by the establishment, by the mainstream media? Only to realize, as an EFF member, pro-EFF, and I'm not voting for MK Party, I'm not gonna join the MK Party. But as an EFF member, I see that no, it's because the MK Party is also fighting for black people. So anyone that fights for black people and is vocal about it, somehow is an enemy to the establishment. Somehow is seen and is gonna be painted as a villain in this political scene. But hey, all the GNU darlings, hey, they are sweethearts, even with all their corruption, even if VBS has been shown and proven that no, it's not the EFF, it's not Julius Malema, it's not Floyd Shivam, but it's the ANC officials. The DA still has the audacity to go to court and get a bunch of old people carrying boards saying we're demanding justice from the EFF. Even though the EFF are not the ones in court, the ones in court are the ANC. How corrupt of this GNU, but the media will protect it so much. But MK Party, EFF, MK Party West now, because a lot of people are joining MK Party and President Jacob Zuma is the biggest threat, because he used to be in the ANC and he's the one they want. If they can get President Jacob Zuma, it's done for black and progressive parties. It's done for the MK Party if the establishment can get President Jacob Zuma, because he seems to be the last hope for a lot of people. And me, as an EFF member, I'm able to analyze that and see that for what it is. And look, let's put the fight against EFF and MK Party aside. Hey, members are switching, joining. Let's put that aside. The mainstream media doesn't report anything good about the EFF. Neither does it report anything good about the MK Party. And these two political parties, yeah, with their small differences, with their own current beef now because of Floyd Chiwambo. With all of that happening, let's put that aside. Let's tone it down when it comes to that. Let's look at the fight they're fighting. They are both in a progressive caucus, fighting against the GNU in parliament. And their policies advocate for the same things. They want the land, they want to save the black life, they want dignity for black people, they want to amend the constitution. So, like, they have a similar fight. And they are both in attack. But President Jacob Zuma seems to be the one they want the most. Because it was fine when he didn't start a political party, was out of the ANC, just sitting back as an old man, regular old man. They never gave him credit for being the former president. They never gave him credit. They never gave him his flowers in the ANC or in government. But he was once the president. Yeah, you can criticize him, state capture, it's fine. You can justify your criticism, it's fine. And I'm not taking that away from you. But the point I'm making is that Now that he has started a political party, and his political party is advocating for fighting for black people, he's now all of a sudden the biggest enemy. He's more of a bigger enemy than Julius Malema now as we speak. Let's be honest. President Jacob Zuma is the biggest enemy now, more than Julius Malema, because of MK Party. And why MK Party? Why the EFF? Why? It's because they are fighting for a black person. They are fighting to take back the land. And they are mobilizing. And look, one thing that a lot of people tend to overlook is that, hey, the MK Party will get into government. Shame on the EFF. It's not shame on the EFF. Hey, the EFF will get into government. Shame on the MK Party. No, we are getting it wrong. It's not shame on anyone. If the MK Party wins, maybe doesn't win majority, but the EFF has enough vote to vote a motion of confidence with the MK Party to amend the constitution to take the land, they will work together. They will work together anyways. So it's a benefit for everyone. Let's put the egos aside. It's fine. Let's put the egos aside. Let's put political parties aside. If these two or even other progressive political parties come together and unite, a black child will win anyways. And the media, the mainstream media, doesn't like that. Why? Why? That's your homework. That's your homework. You should go and do your research. Thank you very much.